today, wonderful people of God. Welcome to another daily charge taken from the Mountaintop Life Daily Devotional. Today is Thursday, November 14, 2024. Let us pray. Our Father, you are the Alpha and Omega, the God of life and light. We thank you because you are the life in us. We are because you are. Be thou exalted in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord God, for that beautiful opportunity to learn at your feet today. As we go into your word, speak to us by your spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Enlarge our hearts to accommodate your word. And let the blessings of your word be our portion every day in the name of Jesus. Thank you, dear Father, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The topic before us today is be filled. Be filled. Our memory verse is taken from Ephesians 5:18. Ephesians 5:18. And it says, "And be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Spirit." Motivational quote. Distraction is a killer of dreams, visions, and goals. Prophetic word for today. Banish the spirit of distraction from your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Our first scripture is taken from the book of John, from John chapter 7, from verse 37 to 39. John chapter 7, from verse 37 to verse 39. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, "If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this speak he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified." Be filled. Be filled. Jesus knew that there is chaos in the world. Following this knowledge, he gave us a way out in our first scripture today. He said, "If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water." Notice the statement, "if any man thirst." To be thirsty means to have a need. It means to have a longing and an urgent need of something. Then he said, "Let him come and drink." In the gospel, we discover that Jesus himself underscored the necessity of the Holy Spirit in the life of the believers. Jesus underscored to us that without the Holy Spirit in the life of a man, in the life of a believer, fulfilling the mandate of God will become so difficult. Living according to divine pattern will become so difficult. Pleasing God will become a struggle without one being filled with the Holy Spirit. Jesus underscored the necessity of being filled with the Holy Spirit to all of us. In the Bible says in John chapter 3, That is when Jesus Christ came to be baptized. He said, after Jesus had been baptized in River Jordan, as he was about coming out of the river, the heaven opened up, and the Spirit of the Lord, like a dove, descended upon him. And a voice came from heaven saying, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased." And from there, chapter 4, the Bible says, and Jesus was led into the wilderness by the Holy Spirit. So Jesus was there in the wilderness. He fasted and prayed for 40 days and 40 nights without eating any food, just for him to be prepared for the ministry. So before Jesus started his ministry, before he began fulfilling his mandate, he had an encounter with the Spirit of God. Jesus himself was saturated by the Holy Spirit. So Jesus has told us that for us to be able to fulfill the agenda of God for us, then we must seek the infilling of the Holy Spirit. There's no man who can do anything in life without the power of the Holy Spirit on the inside. There's no Christian that can do anything worthwhile without the power of the Holy Spirit. That's what the Bible says, it's not by might, nor by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. We all need the infilling of the Holy Spirit in these last days. These last days are critical moments in the history of mankind. There are a lot of things happening around today that anyone who does not carry the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit will just be a gambler on the battlefield of life. Then, in the course of his ministry, Jesus raised 12 disciples, also known as 12 apostles. And then in chapter 10 of the book of Matthew, the Bible says he began to send them out two by two. Then in verse 16 of Matthew chapter 10, Jesus painted to us the metaphorical picture of the ministry of life. He said, I am sending you out as sheep in the midst of wolves. Sheep in the midst of wolves. That is the picture. That is a metaphorical statement about the ministry. And then, before Jesus left, eventually, in Luke 24, verse 49, he said, tarry ye in Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. And we thank God that the disciples understood what Jesus told them. They understood that instruction. They did not rush into ministry. They did not rush to do anything for Jesus Christ. Then in Acts chapter 2, the Bible says, the disciples were gathered together in one accord. And on the day of Pentecost, there was a sound as of a mighty rushing wind. And there appeared to them cloven tongues of fire and sat upon each of them, and they were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. The Holy Spirit came upon the people. They became filled. They became saturated with the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit. And that instruction is for everyone. See, tarry. Don't rush to do anything. Wait. Don't engage yourself in anything until you are filled with the Holy Spirit. And Jesus said that the Spirit of God is available, but for those who are thirsty. And we said here that to be thirsty means you are in need. You acknowledge the fact that, Lord, I am empty. Lord, I need this filling of your Holy Spirit. Because without the Holy Spirit in the life of a believer, he will not be able to please God. Without the Holy Spirit filling the life of a believer, rising and shining will become so difficult. Without the Spirit of God indwelling a believer, working with God will become a struggle and struggle and struggle. So that is the necessity of the Holy Spirit to help us live the way God wants us to live, to help us become the best that God has saved us to be. We must be filled. You must be filled. Every child of God around you, in your church, in your neighborhood who are Christians, must be filled. We must be filled, otherwise we'll be living at the mercy of the enemy. And a lot of Christians today are living at the mercy of the enemy because of the bombardment of the kingdoms of darkness against them. I want you to understand this. You need to be filled with the Holy Spirit for you to become what the Lord has saved you to be. You must be filled. I want you to reflect over this thing. because now we shall be going on a short break. We shall be back to continue. God bless you.
Through your handheld gadgets, you can now have access to your daily devotional, The Mountaintop Live for the year 2024, Volume 9, available through download on the Google Play Store and the iOS App Store. Download yours today. Mountaintop Live Daily Devotional, Volume 9, a life-changing encounter with a God that answered by fire. Mountain of Fire and Miracles Ministries, surely the Lord is here. The Mountaintop Life Daily Devotional for 2024 is now available, Volume 9. Get a copy today and some for those you care about, and leave your days filled with the presence of the Lord. The Mountaintop Life Daily Devotional, Volume 9, Life-Changing Encounter with a God That Answered by Fire. Get a copy, visit www.mfmebooks.com or any MFM bookshop near you. Mountain of Fire and Miracles Ministries, surely the Lord is here.
Welcome back. We'll be discussing this all-important topic. Be filled with what? Be filled with the Holy Spirit. And we have said that Jesus himself underscored the necessity of being filled with the Holy Spirit in his own life and ministry too. And before he was taken up, he told his disciples emphatically, and those who will come after them, people like us and people that will come after us too, if Christ tarries in his coming, that they must not do anything. They should tarry until they are endued with power from on high, until they are filled with power from on high. From the first scripture we read, Christ said, anyone that is thirsty should come to him. Anyone that believes should come to him. And we have explained, as it is written in our devotional, that to be thirsty shows that you have a need. It means you have a longing and an urgent need of something. Then Christ said again, let him come and drink. So you have a need, then you have to come. You know that you have a need, a desire, you need a help, then you don't stop there. You don't stop there. You have to take another step of faith, coming to the one who has promised to give us that living water. So you believe, you know that you have a need. Yes, Lord, I acknowledge this. I need this Holy Spirit. But you don't just stop there. You take a step of faith and go to Jesus, the baptizer with the Holy Spirit himself. If we just explain saying, whoever believeth on me, concerning that need in his life, out of his belly shall flow the rivers of living water. If you now believe that Jesus is the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit, is the one who gives the Holy Spirit as he has promised, then he says, out of the belly of that person shall flow rivers of living water, not dead water, not murky water, not polluted water, but living water, pure living water, water of life that has fire, that has the essence of the Spirit of God within. That is, out of such person or persons who believed shall flow solution to his problem or needs. He will give you that way. You see, many people are going through unnecessary battles today, going from problem to problem, because they have not opened their lives to the Holy Spirit to come in. That is it. Many of the battles confronting people, believers, if they will seek the Holy Spirit, and they allow the Holy Spirit to come in, majority of those problems will be rolled away. Because you cannot carry the Spirit of God and you have been oppressed. You cannot carry the Holy Spirit and you have been afflicted, tormented by spirit wives and spirit husbands. You have been fed by naked trust, force feeding you to eat even things you don't eat in the physical life. Why? Because the Holy Spirit is not on the inside. Our friend the Lord once said it some years back that a woman who was, I think the woman was trusting God for, I think she was having issues. And then when she went for a program, she wanted to go for the prayer group that was dealing with her problem. But they said, the man of God said, no, don't go to that area. Go to the area for Holy Ghost baptism. She was surprised. This is my problem. I want to go to this area of my name. He said, no, go for baptism of the Holy Spirit. And she obeyed and she went to that area. She prayed, she got the Holy Spirit, and then by God's grace, her problem melted away. Have you seen that? So he says, if you believe, out of your belly shall come solution to the problems or the need you have. Living waters, according to that scripture, signifies the Holy Spirit who lives on the inside of every believer who is blood washed. He is the solution to any problem of life. He is our advocate, our counselor, our standby, our comforter, our guide, our intercessor. That is the Holy Spirit. They call him the Paraclete. Paraclete, our comforter. When you have the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit, on the inside of you, by God's grace, there will be solutions to problems confronting you. Not only having solutions, then you also have the power of the Lord God to be able to exercise the dominion that the Lord has given to you through the death, the burial, the resurrection, and the life of Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters, there are powers in this world, and there are powers. Nobody can deny the existence of wicked powers. There are wicked forces. Nobody said no to that. But the greater power, the ultimate power that can subdue, that can paralyze, and that can neutralize all these evil powers is the power of the Holy Spirit. You know that in many places of the world today, there are people who are so bold about their dark power. They go about advertising their dark powers. There are some places, let me say it to you, that wicked masquerades with evil power, they will carry basket, big basket, fill it up with water. They will carry the basket on their head, and there's no drop, no single drop of water will fall on the ground. Evil power. There are many areas like that. They are bound all over. Wicked powers, and they are so confident about their powers, they demonstrate it. There are some places today, there are some wicked herbalists. As they enter inside the forest, they said the leaves will open up their mouth and begin to speak to them. This is my name. I can do this for you. I can do this for you. I can do this for you. There are wicked powers that can travel human beings. They can leave this place. In the next 2-3 minutes, they're in another place. Wicked powers. But the only power that can confront them is the power of the Holy Spirit. So when the Holy Spirit is on the inside of you, he helps you and he gives you solution to long-term battles, generational battles, wicked battles, vertical battles. He gives solutions and also empower you to be able to defeat those powers and begin to live the kind of life that God wants you to live. By believing on Jesus Christ for that particular test or urgent need, you command the presence of the Holy Spirit, your counselor, to give you the solution to that very need, that test that you have. Hence, out of your belly shall flow the counsel of the Spirit of truth to give you light. That is solution to every darkness that is problems of your life. My brothers and my sisters that you are hearing me today, whatever it will cost you, please seek the infilling of the Spirit. Christ said, tarry ye at Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. He said, don't get yourself involved in anything. Life is full of risk. Ministry is full of risks and challenges. Don't make yourself a target to the enemy. Don't give yourself as a prey to the enemy. He said, stay, remain there until you are endued with power, until your life becomes saturated with the power of the Holy Spirit, until you are filled with the Holy Spirit. Jesus himself made his life open to the Holy Spirit. He made himself open to the Spirit of God, and he was able to function in life because he worked in conjunction with the Holy Spirit. That we also, in this generation, this wicked generation now, we need the infilling of the Holy Spirit more than ever before. What is the challenge confronting you? What is that battle that you think that, well, maybe this is how it will continue with me? No, it will not continue like that with you. The ultimate power is with the Holy Spirit. There's no power of any witch or any wizard or cultic agent, powers of your father's house, any power from anywhere that can mess you up when you open up yourself and allow the Holy Spirit of God to saturate you. Are you getting me? The Holy Spirit wants to help you. He is the solution to whatever battle you're passing through. Whatever problem confronts you, the Holy Spirit is the solution. Will you open your life to him today? Will you allow him come in? Jesus allowed him. The apostles, disciples, and all our fathers and mothers in the Lord, those who are doing exploits today, they open their lives up to the Holy Spirit. They are filled, and God is waiting for you. For you also to open your life and ask that the Holy Spirit will fill you. I pray that the Lord will grant you the stand of this today. We shall begin on a short break. We shall be back very soon to continue. God bless you.
Through your handheld gadgets, you can now have access to your daily devotional, The Mountaintop Live for the year 2024, Volume 9, available through download on the Google Play Store and the iOS App Store. Download yours today. Mountaintop Live Daily Devotional, Volume 9, a life-changing encounter with a God that answered by fire. Mountain of Fire and Miracles Ministries, surely the Lord is here. The Mountaintop Life Daily Devotional for 2024 is now available, Volume 9. Get a copy today and some for those you care about, and leave your days filled with the presence of the Lord. The Mountaintop Life Daily Devotional, Volume 9, Life-Changing Encounter with a God that Answered by Fire. Get a copy, visit www.mfmebooks.com or any MFM bookshop near you. Mountain of Fire and Miracles Ministries, surely the Lord is here.
You are welcome back. We will be discussing this seriously important topic. Be filled. This is like a counsel, yeah? It's like an advice. It's like an admonition to you. So you have said that for anyone, any child of God, to begin to manifest that essence of life of Jesus, then we need the Holy Spirit. The out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. However, never try to be led by the Spirit of God until you are filled by the Spirit of God. So if you are not filled with the Holy Spirit, then you cannot be led by the Holy Spirit. It's like a man having a brand new car. You don't have fuel in it, and you say the car will move. How can it move? No, it can't move until you fill it up with fuel. Then the fuel you need is also the Holy Spirit. No man can be led, can be guided without being filled with the Holy Spirit. Notice the words of Jesus. Before the living waters will flow from your belly, you must first come and drink. Now, how are we supposed to drink? According to our memory verse today, the Apostle Paul said, "Be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled with the Holy Ghost." Here, we find the words of Jesus a bit clarified, that by coming to drink, we'll be filled with the Holy Ghost. And according to Jude, verse 20, "But ye beloved, building up yourselves in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost." Your most holy faith is the place of the Spirit. And to build up yourself on your most holy faith means being filled with the Spirit by praying often in the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost wants to possess us, wants to possess you. So the only way to be filled is to come to Him, come to Jesus, accept Him as Lord and Savior. Open your life to Jesus. Let Jesus come in. In fact, Jesus is knocking. He says, I stand by the door. I'm knocking. If anyone hears and opens, I will come in and sup with the person, and the person will sup with me. Jesus is knocking the heart of your life. Enough of struggle, enough of pains, enough of challenge. Let God help you. Then you need to help yourself. How do you help yourself? Open your life to the Holy Spirit. Humble yourself at the foot of the cross again and tell Jesus, the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit, to baptize you with the Holy Spirit. We cannot journey in this life without the Holy Spirit. We cannot confront the powers confronting us without the Holy Spirit. We cannot live a meaningful life without the Holy Spirit. But you cannot do that except you are filled. So humble yourself. Ask that the Holy Spirit will fill you. Begin to live a life of holiness, life of righteousness, the fear of God. Be a man of integrity. Live in the Word of God every day and let the Holy Spirit always have His place in your life. As you do this today, I pray that the Lord will find you clean, open unto Him, and will saturate your life in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will be with you and will give you the wisdom to respond to this. So the bottom line is that no Christian can live successfully or victoriously without the infilling of the Holy Spirit. And God has promised. He said this promise is unto you, your children, your children's children, and those who come after us. Then you are qualified also to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Open your life and let Him come in today, and you never regret it. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we thank You for the Word of Life again. Thank You for Your promise of the Holy Spirit. Lord, we cry unto You today that we are thirsty. We are in need of You, of Your fullness, of Your power, of Your Spirit. Saturate Your children, O God, with Your Spirit today, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the power of the Holy Spirit take over our lives, O God, and let Your joy, Your power, Your victory, dominion, authority be our portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank You, dear Father, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. As you go again today, I commit you to the hands of the Holy Spirit. He will bless you. He will bless your endeavors. I will open and open your life. God bless you, and I wish you the best of the day. In Jesus' name, amen.
God bless you in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank God for the miracle of sleeping and waking up. I decree that today it shall be well with you in the name of Jesus. The Lord God that dwelleth in Zion will move you forward in a new way in the mighty name of Jesus. No evil shall befall you this day, neither shall any plague move near your camp. Wherever you go, the favor of the Almighty shall be upon you. Your life shall be plugged into the socket of divine favor, divine restoration, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. All the evil present in this day, I bind them and I cast them out. You shall not be part of the evil that is spreading around in the name of Jesus. The Lord will make you head and never the tail, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I soak the whole of this day in the blood of Jesus. I soak the whole of this day in the blood of Jesus. You are going in, your coming out shall be blessings. The hand of God shall be mighty upon you. I cover you and your family with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Have a wonderful day, beloved. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen.